Well, it seems like a long time since we had that severe weather, which created potholes in roads up and down Britain, but last year's frost and snow are still taking their toll.
And now a new survey suggests it could take up to 11 years to clear the backlog of repairs needed in England alone. Mark Worthington has the details.
The race is on to patch up the potholes. In the last year, they're thought to have cost local authorities in England and Wales £90 million. And even after a mild winter, there's a backlog on a huge scale.
It is a dream that we are going to get rid of all of them, but I can assure you we're trying our utmost best and I think we're winning the fight.
It's still a bumpy ride for drivers. As quickly as they can be filled in, more holes are appearing. The local government association says councils are chasing their tails trying to keep up. In Leicester, they've fixed 4,000 potholes since last May, and the city's leaders say they can't do it alone.
I predict we'll see roads in crisis condition across the country because of those winters, because of hot summers. The government needs to act now. These cuts in local government budgets when it comes to roads maintenance are a real false economy.
Campaigners for government action say what's causing the problem is far from superficial, and that roads are crumbling because for years they've been given first aid when what they really need is surgery. The Department for Transport says the amount of money councils get to look after their roads is increasing over the next few years, but it also accepts that there's an ongoing need for road maintenance that can't be fixed overnight. In the meantime, councils across the country are smoothing over the problem as best they can. Mark Worthington, BBC News, Leicester.
With us now looking at this is motoring journalist Maria McCarthy.
Good morning.
Good morning.
What I'm always puzzled by is when you drive on the roads in other parts of Europe where they have equally bad, if not worse, winters, their roads always seem to be in better condition than ours.
I think it's partly because they've got better investment in their road surface, partly because they tend to have less traffic than UK roads, and partly because we've got this thing called freeze-thaw. But what happens is water goes into a pothole, it freezes, it expands, the pothole gets bigger, and then because we have like snow, then mild, then snow, then mild, that process increases.
The difficulty is, though, that we're having potholes like this patched up rather than, as we heard, emergency surgery and tarmacking the whole road. But there doesn't seem to be enough money to do that. So what's likely to happen?
Apparently, what we need is to get that money up front. Apparently, it's 20 times more expensive to run around patching up potholes than it would be to actually plan the road maintenance and just do it in advance and just give us some decent roads.
Not helped by the utility companies as well.
Exactly, digging things up every 5 minutes, and they're meant to patch it up again, but they sort of often don't.
It looks
a bit
patch,
it's not very good, and
crack.
It just weakens the road. And also, that one company will dig it up and they'll patch it, and another company will. You know, rather than all sort of like getting together and doing it all at the same time.
Maria, when we spoke to you earlier, we were talking about what drivers can do if they feel their suspension or their tyres are ruined by the potholes in the road, and you said collect the evidence, send it off to your insurers. Loads of people have been writing in to say they've done exactly that, and they've been accused of putting in false claims. Steve and John, they say they ruined their wheels and their tyres, they got nowhere, they complained to their MP, that they would go round and round in circles. Is it really that difficult?
I think it is very difficult, because basically what you've got to do is to prove that the damage to your car was caused by a particular pothole. So you're meant to do things like, you know, take a photograph of the damage, take a photograph of the pothole, but of course, you know, it is actually quite difficult to really, really prove it, because you could have perhaps damaged your car somewhere else and driven it near the pothole, and so on. So I think it's very difficult to defend yourself, and I really feel for motorists with legitimate claims who aren't able to prove their case.
Well, these people have done it, and they've even got AA reports stipulating that the damage was caused by a pothole.
It is very difficult. I think that often, you know, the local authorities, they try and sort of like fob you off a bit, you know, and you have to, like, you know, be one of these awful people who, like, you know, fills in forms in triplicate and is just tremendously persistent. Right. And sometimes even that won't work if they can wriggle out of paying.
An 11-year backlog. Are we ever going to get to catch up with it, do you think?
Apparently it's going to cost £10 billion to get our roads in decent condition again, sort of thing. And it is terrible because it affects everybody. It affects motorists, but also, you know, I feel really sorry for things like cyclists and motorcyclists, you know, vulnerable road users. Exactly, and they could, like, you know, fall off in front of the traffic, you know, because they're sort of bouncing around. You know, it is a very difficult situation.
Yes. All right, Maria, thank you very much. I know you're coming back a little bit later. And we've got the Local Government Association as well. And, of course, councils are in charge of transport. So maybe they'll give us some answers. Thank you for all your thoughts this morning. We've already mentioned a few people writing in to say they tried to claim on their insurance and got nowhere.
Yeah, four brand new tyres, 3 days old, pothole, £175 bill, says Steve, filled in all the forms. Surrey Council wouldn't pay despite the photographs and an AA report stating the pothole was the cause. And it just went on and on and on.
Joanne says she was under the impression we pay road tax for road maintenance. I live in Sheffield. It's one of the worst in the UK. If you're on the back of a bus, it's like a white-knuckle ride.
And Hazel points out something a lot of you get fed up with. The council comes out and repairs one or two potholes and leaves the others nearby untouched.
Oh,
if they looked at the whole stretch of road rather than just one those reported, they could save
trips. And what you get is cars just dodging the potholes. It's so dangerous.
Annoying.
Thank you very much for all your thoughts. Do keep them coming in. Now, it's BBC School Report.